Hi, in today's video, I'm gonna show you how you can fix the most common AC problem under $15, and you can do it yourself. So today I have a little situation in my mom's house. This is my mom's AC. And the unit outside, it does not work. Most of the time, from my experience, I'm not an AC technician, but there's a very simple solution. Most likely, the capacitor is bad. And as a matter of fact, I think I can see why it's bad. You can actually tell by looking on here, and I can see that it's bulging a little bit. The good capacitor, usually it's totally flat. This one has been replaced about 6 years ago, so I guess it's about time. And I see it's bulging, so I'm most likely this is the cause. So I'm just going to replace it with exactly the same one. And here are, of course, you need to remember to disconnect the fuses. And most likely, if you buy the same one, this is 45 plus 5, you can buy it on Amazon from like 10 to, I don't know, maybe 50 bucks. The most expensive I've ever bought was maybe 30 something bucks. So I'm gonna, I have my capacitors right here, and I'm going to disconnect this one and we'll see if that's gonna work. If you have never done it before you remove those cables, make sure that you pay attention to what's written on top. Sometimes there's a bunch of rust, so you need to use little sandpaper to get off. So C, right here there's a letter C, which means this is comes. I'm just going to go and write C, and this is fan on this one. You can actually see it. So this is gonna be fan. I'm gonna put fan, and fan is brown, common is yellow. So that's how we can. So I put common is yellow, fan is brown, and this is Herm. If you can see right here, there's Herm. Herm is blue, so I'm gonna mark it to remove it. Then I'm gonna check the capacitor if it's actually good or bad. Before you check any capacitor, make sure you discharge it, otherwise you're gonna destroy your multimeter. So you need to touch common with Herm to discharge it. This is plastic, so it's not gonna so I'm not gonna get zapped. So discharge it and come on with Herm. Okay, now it's discharged. Okay, now one more thing. Now I want you to pay attention and look at how this is bulged a little bit. This is the brand new one, and as you can see, this one is totally flat. And if I flip it over, you can kind of tell that this one is totally flat. You can see this one is bulging a little bit. So I haven't checked it yet, but I'm thinking that this one is bad now. So let's check it. Okay, now, so let me show you how you check it. So I discharge it, and now I have my multimeter with the option to check capacitance. That's very important. I'll give you the link on the bottom of the video if you want to get this one. This will save you really hundreds of dollars. So this is the bad capacitor that I think it's bad. As I showed you that it's kind of bulging on top of and on bottom. So minus will go on common, which is right here. So if you touch common and then you touch to the opposite, either fan or Herm, you should see a reading over here. I'm touching and there is nothing. That means that capacitor is blown inside. There is not even any connection. I'm touching and there is nothing now. So, and also you can see that when I put it like this, it doesn't even want to stand straight. That's not indication that it's bad. Now this is the good one that I'm going to replace with. It's nice and flat. And now look at this. So this is my common. If I touch to common and a fan, and you gotta wait just a couple of seconds for the multimeters to start reading, it's 4.945. So this is totally fine. So this capacitor is fine when you read 40 on one end and 5 on the other end with plus and minus 5%. So I'm within that range. Now I'm going to go and check Kaman and Herm. On this side, I should have close to 40. So let's see. Okay, 39, 67. So I'm within the range. This one is good. This one is bad. Let me connect this one to AC and we'll see if this is gonna fix everything. Okay, so my capacitor installed. I'm gonna turn the fuses on and we'll see if it's gonna fix the problem. Okay, now moment of truth. Let's see if it's gonna start with the new capacitor. There you go. I've just saved myself at least $150. So this is the quickest fix that everybody can do in your house. If you have a problem where the outside unit does not work, first thing you check capacitor. If that doesn't work, well, then there might be something else like compressor. Then you call your AC guy. If you have any questions, send me an email. I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.